and welcome back to my channel. On today's video, I'm going to be doing a kind of a full face makeup look, but without foundation. I normally don't use foundation during the week, like if I'm just going here and there, and I just kind of really quickly want to cover my under eye circles, look a little bit more awake. I pop a little highlight into the inner corner, I do my brows, I cover up the under eye area with a little bit of concealer, some powder, and blush, and I'm out the door. But today I want to do that, but just a little bit more, I guess, exaggerated and intricate, and then I kind of got a little bit creative with it and decided to just try faux freckles for the first time. So this video is kind of all over the place. See, this is what happens when I get an idea and then I don't know exactly how it's gonna, like how I'm gonna go about it, so then all these things start happening at once and then this is like the final look. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I'm actually like a huge fan of freckles now because I think they look so cute. It's so funny because like growing up, like your mom is always like, don't be on the sun, you're gonna get manchas, because in Spanish manchas are like freckles. If you do naturally have freckles like this, totally enjoy it and love it and embrace it because they're so cute. So I kind of went over like my actual freckles on the side here, which made it a lot easier, but these I had to kind of like, you know, kind of do on my own just like creatively because I don't really have freckles here, I just have them on here. So I could outline these, but these were kind of, here we go, let's get right into the video. All right, so we're starting out with our Mineral Veil Primer from Hourglass, and I like to use this, and I like to focus it on the T-zone because this is where we're going to be applying most of the product on our face. So I'm doing that first, and then I'm going into concealing the under eye area. So I'm using the Becca Under Eye Brightening Corrector, and I'm just applying that into the inner part of the eye and blending it down and out. So I like to focus it in on the inner corner because that's where I want to create the most brightness in the face. So afterwards, I'm just using a dense foundation brush like this one here from Hourglass, and I am just using it to kind of pat down the product and blend it. Now I'm taking the Smashbox Studio Skin 24-Hour Concealer, and this is also a waterproof concealer, by the way, which I think is pretty cool. And I'm just using that, and I'm going over the brightener. As you can see, I'm focusing in on the inner corner of the under eye area, and then just blending it down and out. And I'm also going to be applying it on the bridge of the nose, the forehead, and the chin area. And then just going back in with that dense foundation brush, I'm going to just pat it, almost stamping it into the skin, just using slight circular motions when I blend it out. But I was kind of careful with the outer part of the concealer because I didn't want to really fade away my freckles too much, like my natural ones, because I wanted to go off of my natural freckles in order to create the freckles that I'll be creating in a little bit. So that is what I'm doing there. And then I'm just patting a little bit onto, you know, the eyelid just to neutralize the color there because my eyelids are a little bit darker than the rest of my skin. And this is just more blending, blending, blending. And although we didn't use foundation, you know, we are applying a good amount of concealer, so you will still feel like, you know, you did your makeup and you have a really nice base to work with. Speaking of base, in order to perfect our base, I'm using the NYC Smooth Skin Translucent Powder, and I'm applying that to the under eye area where we concealed in order to bake my face. You can completely bake your face even though you don't have foundation on. You did apply concealer and that's all that matters. So I'm just applying it to all the areas in which I applied that concealer. And also just really quick, big ups to the subby who recommended this powder to me. I do like it. Now for the brows, I'm using the Anastasia Dip Brow Gel and the Brow Gal by Tanya Crooks. Using the Brow Gal pencil first, I'm using the highlighting side, which is just a neutral color, and I'm just using it to outline the brows. It also comes with the shimmer side, which is great for actually highlighting the arch of the brow. And then I'm just taking the Anastasia Dip Brow Pomade in medium brown, and I'm using an angled liner brush. This one is from e.l.f., very inexpensive, by the way. And I'm just using it to outline the brow and then fill it in nicely. And I'm going for a more natural brow today, so it's not gonna be as stark and as, you know, like, I don't know how to explain it, but just, it's just gonna be more natural, you know? And then once I'm done filling it in, I'm going to go ahead and just take a flat lined brush, and I'm going to use that to blend the highlighting shade downward. As you can see, it's going to leave like a really nice look to the brows, and it's going to make them look like you just got them done when you really didn't. Once that's done, I'm using my e.l.f. contour kit. I'm going to use the lightest contour shade. And it's been a while since I've used it, but I remember how much I love it now. And I'm just using it along the cheekbones. We did not apply foundation here. So, you know, it's gonna take some time to work with it. But actually, these contour creams are great even without foundation on the face. It still looks really nice and natural, and it doesn't look very, it doesn't look weird. Because when you don't wear foundation, it could be hard to apply contour shades. It could be hard to apply a blush because it just looks streaky. But this didn't look streaky after I blended it out. And then once we go ahead and blend out that powder, it looks even better. So I think we're gonna do that now. Yeah, we are. So now we're just taking a fluffy brush, and I am just going in for it. I am blending out that translucent powder. And this powder does leave just a little bit of like a powdery look, just a tiny bit. I still like it for every day because it is worth it, and it's only $3. And so I do like it, but yeah, it's a little bit hard to blend out. It won't blend out as easy as obviously the Laura Mercier, but it is still really good. As you can see, it does the job. Now going in for blush, I'm using this kind of peachy rose color from Bobbi Brown. It's in Tawny, I believe, number 2, and I'm just applying that onto the cheekbones. Or just the cheeks, actually, not the cheekbones. The cheekbones was for the contour. So these were just applying to the cheeks. Now just drawing on my faux freckles, I'm just taking this small little, I don't even know what kind of brush this is. It's like a small shadow brush from e.l.f. But it's small enough to create some very small circles. So I'm just using a brown eyeshadow. This one is the shade Walnut from the Lorac Mega Pro 3 palette. And I use this eyeshadow a lot just for pretty much everything. So I decided to use it for my freckles because it was the one that matched my actual freckles color the best. So I'm just creating random freckles along my nose because I don't actually have freckles there. But as I said earlier, I did use my actual freckles as a little bit of a guide to kind of show me, hey, like this is what freckles look like. So, you know, go for it. And then once I've decided that enough freckles are on my face, I'm just going to take my beauty blender. It does not have to be damp. Matter of fact, probably do it with a dry beauty blender and just kind of stamp it and onto the skin. As you can see, it kind of removes the darkness of the eyeshadow that you applied, and it kind of makes it look more like it's, you know, like a natural looking freckle. So definitely pat it with a dry beauty blender because I'm not sure what a wet beauty blender would do. So don't try that. And I just took a little bit of that translucent powder from the other side of the beauty blender and just added it on top and then kept stamping it in just to create a natural look. Now onto the eyes, I'm going to be taking, I believe it's called Kava. And it's a beautiful, beautiful highlight shade from the Mega Pro 3 palette. And I'm applying it into the inner corner of my eyes. And I'm just blending it about a quarter way through onto the lid. Now taking, I believe this is Pink Bronze from the palette, I am going to apply it into the rest of the lid area. And these colors are so easy to work with. There's virtually no room for error here because they're just so easy to blend and so shimmery and so soft. So I'm just applying that into the rest of the lid area. Then I'm going to take Walnut from the palette, which is a matte light brown color, and I'm just going to pop that into the crease just to try to create more defined look. Now just taking a nude eyeliner, and I'm going to apply it into the waterline to kind of make my eyes look a lot brighter and a lot more awake. Now I'm going to just do my normal routine. I'm applying my mascara, which is the Clinique Flutter to Full Mascara. It has 3 dials where you can kind of determine how much mascara you want to be on your eyes. And I'm just applying a light coating of it to my top and bottom lashes before I apply falsies, which I actually didn't apply on camera. Sorry guys. So they're already on my eyes, and now I'm just applying Walnut to the lower lash line just to kind of add a little bit of, you know, intensity to the eye. And I just kind of like doing this, you know, with my eye looks, just adding a little bit to the lower lash line. And I'm adding a little bit more of that brightening eyeshadow into the inner corner. And then I'm also adding just a little bit of it to my top lip, the Cupid's Bow, before I apply my favorite lip liner. This is my favorite lip liner to wear by itself. It's Candy K from Kylie Cosmetics. And I just find it creates this beautiful, I don't know, it's just perfect for the lips. And I feel it's so close to my natural lip color that it just looks so, so pretty. And then I go ahead, I line, and then I fill it in. And I'm usually good to go. I don't even need to apply a liquid lipstick if I don't want to. I could just leave it like this for a more kind of natural, everyday look. Now, highlight, can't forget that. I'm adding Champagne Pop from Becca Cosmetics into the cheekbone area. And I think I did about 3 coats here, and then I just went ahead and just blended it. So 3 coats like this with a dry brush is what this is gonna get you. And I also applied it into the brow bone as well, as you can see. And boom, that's the finished look. This is the finished look. I hope you guys enjoyed it. If you're new to my channel, don't forget to subscribe, click that red button down there, and turn it gray for me by clicking it. And I can't wait to film the next video for you guys. I actually do have an announcement to make this week. There is a huge change happening in my life, and I've been kind of hiding it from you guys for I've been waiting to just announce it to you guys for like the longest time, because I wanted to make sure that everything was in motion and everything was gonna work out and all that stuff before it happened. But it is happening, and I'm like, I can't wait to share with you guys. So please be on the lookout for an announcement video. But I do think I am actually gonna just tell you guys on social media. So follow me on Instagram, Snapchat for sure, Instagram for sure, like Twitter. You know, all my links are down below for you guys, because I think I'm going to let you guys know on Friday, but I'm not 100% sure. So I'm just like really excited about it. I'm like, I feel like a little schoolgirl. The freckles aren't helping, but yeah, so stay tuned for that. But yes, other than that, I will see you guys again very soon in my next video. Bye.